Yes, welcome to the online lecture on Unit 2, that is data flow modeling as well as gate level modeling. The first part of this Unit 2 is data flow modeling. So here we are studying two particular topics in this session. The first being continuous assignments and its deviations or its features, its types, and then delays associated with these continuous assignments. So these are the things that we are studying in today's class. A continuous assignment is a basic statement in data flow modeling used to drive a value onto a net. Meaning is, continuous assignment statements means whatever assign you use and followed by LHS or RHS, all these are called as assignment, continuous assignments. So equal to operator, we call it as continuous assignment operator, okay, statement. The continuous assignment replaces gates in the description of the circuit and describes circuit at higher level of description, abstraction. The meaning is, no need to mention that whether it is AND gate or OR gate and all. If you just assign something on the right hand side with the left hand side, that is also a continuous assignment. So that is defining the circuits at the highest level of abstraction. That's the meaning. A continuous assignment statement starts with the keyword assign. So data flow style of modeling means assign should be the keyword present in all of the Verilog codes. The syntax of an assign statement is as follows. So here it is. First, you should write assign. Drive strength is an optional thing. It's an optional thing. You can leave it or you can include it. And even this is optional. Delay, mentioning delay is an optional. Okay. Then followed by list of the assignments. So list of the assignments is, you can have y is equal to a ampersand b, whatever we write in that manner is called as list of assignments. There you have an option to mention drive strength as well as delays. Okay, so this is the actual syntax of the assignment statements, which we were not worried while conducting the experiments in the lab. We never worried about drive strength, we never worried about delays. But even that can be put here. Continuation. The drive strength is optional and can be specified in terms of strength levels of value sets that we have discussed earlier. We have already discussed before the start of data types regarding drive strengths. You have strong one, weak one, strong zero, weak zero, supply one, supply zero, and many more. So here, if you don't mention anything, what is the default value that is considered by the Verilog constructs? The default value of the drive strength is strong 1 and strong 0. Okay, so these are the default values. If you don't mention anything, it will consider that you have mentioned, as if you have mentioned strong 1 and strong 0. So the delay value is also optional. Delay value is also optional. Drive strength is also optional. And it can be specified, used to specify delay on the assign statement. And this is like specifying delays for the gates. Like you are assigning certain time for the delays to respond for the change at the input. That's the meaning. And you are aware that time is needed for anybody in this world to respond to it. For example, if I ask a question to you, you take some time to respond to me. Whether it is online mode or if you are physically present in front of you, whatever question I ask, first, immediately you don't start responding. You will take certain time and then you will respond. That time is needed for everyone. Even it is true with the gates. So delays associated with gates are predominantly existing because we need to assign, we need to give some time for each of the circuits and the gates to respond for the input change. Immediately nothing happens. Everything needs its own time. Okay, so few things can be defined by the user. Few things, if you don't define also, it will exist, pre-exist. Okay, so those such delays will be studying in the later stage in the slides today's session. So continuous assignments have the following characters. These characters you need to observe carefully. Of course, these are full statements. I just to give clear idea, I have put it. I'll just highlight the important things. The left hand side of the assign statement. Left hand side, I hope you understand. Assign, left hand side equal to right hand side. That's how is the syntax. Left hand side of an assignment must always be a scalar or a vector or net or a concatenation of scalar or net vectors. So what is this concatenation? We'll worry about it later again. In the same chapter, we'll be learning about lot of various operators that we have in the Verilog. So that time we'll discuss about it. So this statement can be put in the other way. It cannot be a scalar or a vector register. That's the meaning. Whenever you use assign operator, assign keyword on the LHS, you are not supposed to have a scalar or vector register. Reg type is not allowed. That's the meaning. Okay. Continuous assignments are always active. One second. Continuous assignments are always active. The assignment expression is evaluated as soon as one of the right hand side operands change and value is assigned to the left hand side net. What is its meaning? The meaning of it is, whenever you have LHS and RHS, the RHS values, maybe I'll take an example of assign y is equal to a ampersand b. Here a ampersand b is RHS and y is LHS, and here it says that continuous assignments are always active. Means whenever there is a change in the value occurring on the RHS, whenever there is a change in the value of a and b variable which are present on the RHS, immediately the operation starts and value will be computed, and whatever the new value that is computed will be assigned to the LHS. So this process will be happening continuously. Okay, the operands on the right hand side, operands means a and b here. See, I'll write it here, assign y is equal to a ampersand b. So here assign is a keyword, y is the output, this equal to operator is a continuous assignment operator. So this y is a variable, of course, exists on the LHS. A and b are the operands, ampersand is the operator. So this exists on the RHS. Okay, now you understand what's the meaning of operands. The operands a and b on the right hand side can be a register type or net type or function calls. Regarding this function calls, again we will have it in the separate chapter. Registers or nets can be scalars or vectors. All these are allowed on the RHS, but only on the LHS you should not have a register. Remember, y cannot be a register, but a and b can be register or a net or a concatenation, whatever it is. Delay values can be specified for assignments in terms of time units. Delay values are used to control the times and when net is assigned to the evaluated value. The feature is similar to specifying delays for gates. It is very useful in modeling timing behavior in real circuits. Okay, so we'll study separately about delays. Here we have certain examples on continuous assignments. Assign out is equal to I1 ampersand I2. Same thing I had taken an example. Rather than out, I was calling it as Y. I1 and I2 in place of A and B. Okay. This is a continuous assignment statement. Now here we have one more declaration. Assign address of 16 bit, print out to 0, is being assigned with the RHS expression address 1 underscore bits of 16 bit, XORed with address 2 underscore bits 16 bit. Even this is a valid statement. Even this is a perfectly valid statement. You might be thinking, like, I should declare this, I have these vectors. Why I need to write this? I can just write ADDR equal to ADDR 1 underscore bits. Even that is okay. This is written because think that you might be having ADDR of 32 bits. This might be of some other bits. This might be of some other bits. I want to perform XOR operations only on the 16 bits of my choice. So I have a option to select the vector part of the vector. This is how we select the part of the vector. This is how we select the part of the vector. Okay, this we call it as vector part select.
and this 16 bit vector, this 16 bit vector part, I am performing XOR and I am assigning it to the 16 bit LHS. Okay, that's it. Concatenation. Regarding concatenation, we'll study in detail, but in short, concatenation operator will be having two flower brackets, opening and closing, followed by comma. So whatever you write here and whatever you write here, both will be joined together. So where these two things will be joined together forms a bigger vector. For example, assign concatenation operator followed by semi comma. I am having C out and I am having some expression. This is of 4 bits and this is of 1 bit. Totally we have will be having 5 bit output. So A is of 4 bit, B is of 4 bit, 4 bit addition plus CA. Okay, this is a ripple carry adder. So it will generate 4 bit sum output and a carry output. So I'll combinedly write it in this fashion. This is also a valid statement. Okay, see how simple my job is. On the other side, you have 4 bit ripple carry adder, and here you are using 2 plus operators. That's it. Both are doing the same work. Okay, this is a concatenation operator. So concatenation operator is valid to be used on the LHS. That's the meaning. Okay, next, implicit continuous assignment. What's the meaning of implicit continuous assignment? So implicit means something which is understood already by default. That's the meaning. No need to mention it separately. That's the meaning of implicit if you go by English dictionary. Okay? Instead of declaring a net and then writing a continuous assignment on the net, Verilog provides a shortcut by which continuous assignment can be placed on a net where it is declared. Self-explanatory statements. There can be only one implicit declaration assignment per net because the net is declared only once. I'll just take an example. An implicit assignment statement is contrasted with regular continuous assignment. So this is a thing that we have just discussed just now. And this is a new one, implicit continuous assignment. What is the difference here? Both are doing same work. But here I am having two statements. Here I am having one statement which is performing the same operation, reducing my work. Wire out. Out is a variable, net variable. Next, I am using assign out is equal to IN1, ampersand IN2, semicolon. Here, I can directly write wire. I can skip this. I can take this out. Wire out equal to IN ampersand I2. This is also valid. So, wire out will be declared first. And when out is declared with net type wire, then this will be assigned with IN1, ampersand IN2. So this is nothing but two instructions will be executed at a time. So no need to implicitly write assign statement. That's the meaning of implicit continuous assignment. While declaring itself, I am performing assignments, continuous assignments. So this is called implicit continuous assignment. So, continuous assignments, then implicit continuous assignments and its characteristics. Now, next comes delays, very important topic. So, delay values control the time between change in the right hand side operand and when the new value is assigned to the left hand side. So, where does the delays comes into act? For example, you have LHS and RHS. Here you have LHS and RHS. If I mention a delay, the delay is given to the gate means this will compute a value, the AND operation will compute a value, it will assign to the output only after the specified delay. That's a meaning. That's a meaning here. It's a time between the change in the right hand side operand and when the new value is assigned to the left hand side. So there are three ways of specifying delays. Three ways of specifying delays in this continuous assignment statement. First one is regular assignment delay. Next is implicit continuous assignment delay. Implicit, you remember the meaning of, English meaning of it. Net declaration delay. So these are the three types that we are discussing now. So regular assignment delay is the first delay that is under our focus. The delay value is specified after keyword assign. That's already we know. Any change in the value IN1 or IN2 will result in a delay of 10 time units before recomputation of expression of this, and the result is assigned to out. So this statement I have written by referencing to this particular assignment operator. What I'm doing here, assign hash 10 followed by hash whatever we write, it is a delay unit. 10 time units. You read that's 10 time units. And what is a time unit? So time unit can be specified with tick back tick time scale before the start of your Verilog code. It's a compiler directive. Okay. So here what is happening is any change in the value IN1 and IN2. Any change in these two values will result in 10 time units delay. So this will be updated to out only after this much time of the delay. Think that there is a change in the value of these two things or any one of these things. And operation is performed already. But for assigning 10 time minutes, it will wait. Got it? So 10 time minutes, it will wait. Then only it will be assigned to the out variable. If IN1 or IN2 changes value again before 10 time minutes, when the result propagates to out, the value of IN1 and IN2 at the same time will be recomputation are considered. This property is called inertial delay. So regular assignment delay is also called as inertial delay. So this is very important to remember. An input pulse that is shorter than the delay of the assignment statement does not propagate to the output. So to explain it, I need to take an example. I'll take an example. Just have a check. Same statement I have taken here. Assign hash 10 out is equal to IN1 ampersand IN2. If I draw the timing diagram, this is how the input is. At 10 time minutes, IN1, IN2 is 0. Till 20 time minutes, it is continuing the same. At 20 time minutes, both IN1 and IN2 are getting changed. And after 60 time minutes, IN1 is again changing its value to 0. And here it is a very important observation. At 80, IN1 is changing to 1, but at 85, it is dropping down. You observe this input pulse. This input pulse is, pulse width is how much? This input pulse width is 5 time minutes. And here the delay specified is 10 time minutes. Now you read the statement. An input pulse that is shorter than the delay of the assignment statement. The input pulse 5 time minutes, that which I just now shown. This is an input pulse which is 5 time minutes, means which is shorter than the delay of the assignment. Delay of the assignment is 10. 5 is shorter than the 10, which will not propagate to the output. It will not propagate to the output. So output will just ignore this. Why it is done so? That we will discuss now. This timing diagram is explained neatly here. See. IN1 ampersand IN2. At here, the value is 00. This value is computed. Ampersand, 0 ampersand 0 is 0 itself. But that 0 will not be updated here. Rather, it will be updated after 10 time minutes. After 10 time minutes, your output goes to 0. See here, after 10 time minutes, your output goes to 0. Now, here it is 00, so it will continue as it is. Where there is a change? Here there is a change. Here there is a change. So logic 1 here. So logic 1 ampersand with logic 1 is 1 itself. But when it will happen? After 10 time minutes. Here it is happening. Logic 1. After 10 time minutes it is happening. Okay. When signal IN1, IN2 goes to high at 20, output goes to high 10 time units later, that is time 30. That's amazing. Then IN1 goes to low at 60. IN1 goes to low at 60. But this is logic 0. This is logic 1. 0, 1 is ANDed is. ANDed operation will give you logic 0. That logic 0 is updated after 10 time units. Output changes to low after 10 time minutes. That's amazing. Now, if IN1 changes to high at 80, this one, very important. OK, okay, but it goes down to low before 10 time units have elapsed. It is coming down to low before 10 time units. After 5 time units itself, it is coming down. Then, at the time of recomputation, 10 units after time 80, I in 1 is 0. Thus, output gets the value 0. So, what happens is, at 90, your output tries to update. But here it checks that its value is 0. Its value is, here its value is 1, its value is 1. It should have been 1, but currently it will check it has changed. So, hence it will not update its value. It will not update its value. So, a pulse of width less than the specified assignment delay is not propagated to the output. So, this will be not propagating to the output. That's the meaning. This is called inertial delay. I hope there are no doubts. Next comes implicit continuous assignment delay. This is an equivalent method used for implicit continuous assignment to specify both the delay and a assignment on the net. See, this is the normal way. Wire out assign hash 10 out equal to in ampersand I. Now, for implicit operation, this can be ignored. Out and assign can be ignored. I can write wire hash 10 out equal to in 1 ampersand in 2. So, this is called implicit continuous assignment delay. You know, I just go to the previous slides. Implicit continuous assignment means wire out assign out equal to, this can be written as wire out equal to in ampersand in 2. I will specify the delay here. Hash 10, that's it. Just by specifying hash 10, we call it as implicit continuous assignment delay. That's it. Okay, this is just additional option that Verilog is providing to you. You may use it or you may not use it. It is left to your comfortability. The declaration above has the same effect as defining a wire out and declaring a continuous assignment on the output. Next, net declaration delay. So, what is net declaration delay? A delay can be specified on a net when it is declared without putting a continuous assignment on the net. If a delay is specified on the net out, then any value changes applied to the net out is delayed accordingly. For example, you can see here, wire here hash 10 out. For definition, for declaration itself, I am mentioning some delay. Means whenever you use that particular net out, so it is like you are specifying it together with a delay. Hash 10 is present here, that is how is the assumption. So I in 1 and I in 2 will be updated to the LHS only after waiting for 10 time units. That's the meaning. It's as good as writing in this manner. That's the meaning of net declaration delay. So with this, the next topic is expression operators and operands. We'll learn about it after IAS. Up till here, you have portions for your IAS. If you have any doubts, I'll take it, or else I'll just show some example in the Xilinx environment. Please come up in the chat box if you have any doubts. I'll just open the Xilinx. So I'm waiting for your reply. Yes, students, I'm waiting for your reply. If you have any doubts, please come up in the chat box. If not, at least say that you don't have any doubts. If you have anything to be asked related to IAs or whatever is in your mind, that you can definitely ask. So if you don't have any doubts, let me just take the Xilinx. I'll share my screen. Okay, hope my screen is visible to you. So this is Xilinx environment. Let me create a new project because it is unit 2. So unit 2. Unit 2 examples. All details are there. I have a code with me. Let me for explaining regular delay. So I'll create new source Verilog module, same name I'll give. I'm just copy pasting the pre-written code to save the time. Module to end module, I'll copy it. So the code is ready. So I'll save it. After saving, I'll just synthesize it. Double click and synthesize it. Wait until it gets synthesized. Here you can see, I'll just zoom it out. You can see that assign hash 10 out equal to in ampersand in I in 1 and I in 2 is handed. Okay. And regular delay output input 1 input 2, all these are. This is a code. Okay, same code. Only thing is I had shown only this to make it execute. They should be declared as output. There should be these two things should be declared as input that I have done. Okay, so synthesis is done. Now I'll go for stimulus writing. New Verilog fixture. I have already written the code. Stimulus. Stimulus. Next. So it has been associated with regular delay module. So it's getting opened. Stimulus block is getting opened. So here it has opened. Automatic declaration, everything is there. From here, things to be put. I don't copy everything here. I just copy since hash 20. Okay. So only this much I'll copy. Okay. Hash 20. So the stimulus block is ready. Save it. Keep it to the simulation so that this will be visible. You can see that plus mark. You have regular delay as a unit under test. Now I'll run it. I'll just run it. So this has been designed in the same way. There is some error. 51th line. I in 1 is not declared. 47th line. So small and big letter, that's the difference. Last class I had explained you related to actuals and formals. Okay, so here whatever are there that should be put. Of course I'll change it here itself. This is capital and as it is case sensitive, it's not allowing, so I'll change it to small I in 1. Let me zoom it out so that you can also see it. So It is capital case, that's why it is not working. In. Next, I am changing here also. In. Okay. So I think now the problem might have got solved. So I saved it. Again, I'll rerun it. Run it. So simulation behavioral model completed successfully. Okay, so I just changed that values and it executed successfully. So here, zoom to full view. Okay, and let us check here. This is IN1, or can I place it? Yeah, can check here the waveform that I have discussed here. This waveform and not this one, this one. Okay, this waveform and this waveform. You just compare. At 20 time units or at 10 time units, your output is changing to logic 0. Your output is changing to logic 0. At 20 time units, IN1 and IN2 are going 1, but output updates after 10 time minutes. At 20 time minutes, nanoseconds, your IN1 and IN2 are going 1, but its respective output, handing operation output, will be updated only at 30 nanoseconds. Okay. Next is, at 60 means we are already given command up till 20. After 40, 20 plus 40, after 40, IN1 is going to plus 40. That's why the code is written in this fashion. After 40, IN1 is going to 0. After 40, IN1 is going to 0. But this will be reflected to the output only after 10 time minutes. Same as here. Here. At 70, it is going down. And after that, 80, 85 observe. At 70, it is going on. And here, of course, 80, 85, it should have been from 60 plus 20. It should have been plus 20, but I made it as plus 40. Plus 40. Let it be. You just concentrate here. It is only for 5 time minutes, which is less than the delay specified. Hence, it is going unnoticed. 1 should have been 1 here, but it is going unnoticed. So, this kind of pulse input will not be propagated. That's it. Okay. So this is a delay example. Let me close it. Okay. So next we had implicit delays and all. Let me check if I have that codes. I'll take implicit delay example to just explain. Implicit delay. I'll go to implementation, then I'll create a new Verilog file, Verilog module, implicit delay, next, finish. I have the codes, I'll just copy paste it. Let me make this as a top level module, set top level module, okay, set top level module. Then you have this editor window, I'll just copy the code. Okay, save it, synthesize it by highlighting implicit underscore delay. If you don't set it to set top level module, then here you don't get all these processes. You'll get only check syntax option. Okay, so that's why I have set it to top level module. Wait until it gets synthesized. You can see here, I'll just zoom it. Wire hash 10 out equal to IN1 ampersand IN2. Here, what all things we have escaped or skipped? Wire out should have been declared first, and after that, assign hash 10 out, same this expression should be, have been written. But I have merged this. It is called implicit delay. So whether it works or not, that will check. Again, I'll go to new file. I'll just create a simulation stimulus file for this. Right click, new source, Verilog test fixture, stimulus, next. Do you want to replace? Stimulus is already there. Okay, let it be. I give it a stimulus 1. Okay, next. So which one you want to associate with? So implicit delay is a thing that we are focusing now. Regular delay is already done. Hence, I'll highlight this. Click on next, finish. Okay, so it'll open the file. You have to wait for a while. So I'll zoom it. So stimulus 1, so the code is already there. So here I'll update with same cases, hash 1022, this one. Okay, I'll update here. Fine. So here it was hash 40. I make it as 20 in order to compare it with the example of the textbook example as it is. Here again, I'll make it to IN 1, IN 2, IN 1, IN 1, IN 1. Okay. So save it. And then go to simulation. So here two simulations are there. I'm selecting simulation 1 and simulate behavior 1. Just wait for this one. So here, you know, stimulus name was already present. Hence, I named it as stimulus 1. It should not create any problem. So it's completed successfully. I'll just have to wait for ICM simulator. Zoom to full view. So you can check the same thing you are getting. Up till 10 time minutes, no output. I'll keep the output here. At 20 time minutes, it is changing, but it is reflecting at 30 time minutes. At 60 nanoseconds, it is changing, but at 70 nanoseconds, it is reflecting. At 80 to 85, you can see here. From 80 to 85, there is a logic 1, both logic 1, but in at output it is going unnoticed. This is the reason. And after 150 time minutes, it is stopping after that. Okay. So this is a reason for, you know, this pulse to be mandatorily more than the delay specified. Okay. So that's implicit delay for you. Implicit delay. Okay. Now let me take net declaration delay. So net declaration delay is like I declare the net declaration delay and I'll show it. Okay, so I'll just take it. Open the Xilinx window. Before that, I'll close the stimulus block. Okay, now I'm here. So I go for the new code, new source, Verilog file. Now I am going with net declaration. Next, next, finish. Okay. So here I'll copy the code. Now net declaration. I'll paste it here. Implementation. So I set this net declare to the top level module. So I set it. Now I synthesize it. I have saved it and I'll synthesize it. So till it synthesizes, let me get ready with next one. Let me name it as stimulus 2. Okay, stimulus 2. Until it completes its process, I think next process will not be allowed for taking place. I will wait for a while. Here it is simple. Yeah, there is no delay mentioned, but I'll mention it in the stimulus block. Because it is delay, I'm explaining you the delay, that's why. Stimulus 2. So which we want to get associate? I want to associate with net declare. Hence, click that, click on next, finish. So if you do that, your stimulus block pre-written code will have the code where design under test would be selected of net underscore declare. That's why. Okay. Next, I'll just copy the same thing which I had in the previous case. So you should get the same output. Okay. I'll save it and go to stimulus simulation. Highlight the stimulus 2 and double click on simulate behavioral model. Okay. So wait for iSim simulator to get opened. So this is today I took all delay examples, but I did not take any examples for data flow style of modeling because it has already been explained in your physical class. All the codes, it may be priority encoder or decoder, DMux, 4:1 mux, 8:1 mux, lot many things, full adder, full subtractor, all those things have been discussed in the physical class, hence I am not taking it here. Okay, so here the values, the input cases have been given separately. Once again, delay, actually it is implicit, I'll check the value. Yeah, here there is a mistake. So I should have given net, see you just observe, if there are no delay mentioned, this is how the output will be. When 0, 0, output is 0. When it goes to 1, immediately it is going to 1. When it is having pulse of any width, it is showing the output. But now, I make the changes here. Here, net declaration delay I provide. Hash 10. See here. I'll zoom it and show. Here I changed it with this one. Initially it was not present. Okay. Now I save it. Now I run it. Before running it, I'll close this existing simulation window. You remember this for the comparison, okay? Close this. There is no delay here. Immediately it is reflecting at the output. But here I've changed it to net declaration delay. I've given net declaration delay. I saved it, highlighting it, I'll simulate it. Now we'll see what happens. Completed successfully. Zoom to full view. You can see here. Now the delays are witnessed. After 10 time minutes, it is getting updated. Keep in the same manner. Okay. So this is changing to 1. After 10 time minutes, it is updating. And this is changing its value. After 10 time minutes, it is updating. And this 80 to 85, that's just 5 pulse width. Is getting ignored at the output. So this is net declaration delay. Okay. Okay. I explained all these things on the slides as well as with the Xilinx. Okay. So this wire hash 10, that's what I did. Okay. If you have any doubts, I'll take it or else we'll stop. Any doubts, students? Was the delay concept got clear to all of you? Please come up in the chat box.
Quick. Was the Xilinx simulation based teaching helped you in understanding? Yes. Okay. Fine. Good. Good to know it.